ago, TJ, back with another video. A little bit of a different video because I'm actually going to do a pickup vlog, and I will be able to show you the Air Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard 3.0 in hand, not my pair. I have kept the same energy. This was not a shoe I cared for when I first saw the, you know, the pics come out and us get those first early looks. So I've kept that same energy, not something that I wanted. Not to mention, still October, still trying to do my best, no pickup. So this is not for me, not even my size, just doing a favor. But you guys will get to go along with me. So, you know, switch the content up a little bit. So I'll try to get this out today. On Saturday, I'm going to show you guys what I got on. I decided to go ahead and rock with the Shattered Backboard Jordan 1 Low. And I did a lace swap. So shout out to my guy, Ray on IG. I will make sure that I put his Instagram. He takes amazing sneaker pics. He's not on YouTube, but he's on IG. Takes amazing sneaker pics. He just hit 8K. I think 8K. No, 9K. I think he hit 9K. On IG, so shout out to Ray, he deserves every single follower that he has. I had to steal his style because he had on the camo with these and the lace swap, and I just thought it was a perfect way. You guys, I mean, I'm gonna throw something on, it's kind of cold and raining, but thought this shirt was very fitting as well. You know, very fitting. All right, guys, so let's just go head to the mall. First Saturday that I don't work and I still have to go to the mall. Ain't that something. At the mall, and it is raining. This is actually one of those days I'm really glad that I don't work, because it means that I can take my butt right back home, hop into a sweatshirt, and watch football all day and really do nothing. But I am gonna go ahead and get this pickup done, show you guys what the shoe looks like, and then, you know, I'm just gonna be honest, we can do like a short recap of release. I know I give you guys that all the time on a consistent basis, but it's gonna be a real short recap. Let's just put it that way. If you're wondering what this is, so it's actually a Nike Tech Fleece poncho. It came out for women a few years ago. It's kind of hard to, you can't find it on the market anymore, so you do have to go like eBay or Poshmark to be able to get it. I got this one on eBay. I have a gray one that I got on eBay as well, and as soon as my mom saw this, she loved it, so I then had to go and get my mom one, find her one on eBay. Ladies, if that is something that you want, listen, just go search Nike fleece poncho on eBay and you can probably look up and find one of these. The prices just will simply vary, but hey, it's something that is really nice. It's better than your average quality sweatshirt because it is tech fleece. It's got pockets, so it's got all the tech fleece features. Just, you know, really dope funnel hood. All right, let me run in here, do this, and then I will wrap this video up and catch you guys later. Gotta breathe a little bit, gotta let the arms breathe a little bit. So this is the Nike Anniversary Tee, because I know somebody is going to ask. It is one of my favorite pickups of all time of this year. I actually got it at work, so it is available in kids. I think it's available in men's too. So if you wanna check this shirt out, it has a lot of micro branding, and that's what I like about it. So this is the shoe that that we are looking over today. So it is the Air Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard 3.0. So it is the latest rendition in the whole Shattered Backboard line. Now we all know this has to do with an exhibition game in which Michael Jordan broke the backboard. And I know Seth Fowler alluded to the fact that maybe the finish on this shoe is paying homage to what shattered glass would look like. And I can see that. It doesn't mean that I rock with it, but I can see that. 100%. So you see, I like to listen. I feel like it has a glycerin look. If anybody's ever done a fitness photo shoot or video shoot, a lot of times glycerin is put on your body to really accentuate and give it that, you know, really sweaty, work to the bone, tired, exhausted, you know, dripping sweat look for a workout. It's not fun to have it on. Let me explain this to you. It sucks. And this is exactly kind of what this shoe reminds me of. Like, it has that glycerin look. Again, for anybody that's gonna say, oh my God, I thought you weren't mine. This is not mine. It is a 5.5. I rock a 6.5 in Jordan 1s. You've seen me do my pickups of Jordan 1s and they're a 6.5, okay? Favors are done. So mind your business. This is not my size. This is a 5.5, but I am doing my best, my due diligence to try to bring you guys content that I know you may be interested in. So this is what the shoe looks like. Now I will say this, even though I'm not a fan of the shoe, point blank period, they actually did pretty well just in terms of the feel. So the side panels are actually pretty soft, which I like. I think that's a good deal for you guys. I mean, the toe box is patent leather. I don't think that it matters. You know that this is going to crease, but it's a Jordan 1, so you've already come to that conclusion. For grade school, you have seen this a thousand times, but the lace bag, there's absolutely nothing on it, and this lace bag is pretty much full because it's a smaller one versus the men's pair, which does have that red line and the Jumpman on there, so just be aware of that. The actual midsole does have this. It's not even an off-white. It's like, it's really like an aged midsole. I think that's what they're kind of going for. I don't like it on this shoe, but I do like it on other sneakers that I've seen it on. So there are some New Balances for women, some 997 Sports, that actually do have this yellow aged midsole on it, and it actually looks really good. I just don't know that I'm feeling it for this particular shoe. It's a standard Jordan 1 tongue with the Nike Air on there. If you look on the inside, and trust me, your pair should have that Jordan 1 smell. You have the insole, has Nike Air on it as well. So you get the traditional black laces. I'm gonna be honest, I'm starting to do white lace swaps a little bit more. So I saw my guy Ray do a lace swap on his with the white. I absolutely loved it. So I did that this morning and this is what I rocked. I actually got quite a few compliments walking through the mall with the lace swap on. So hey, shout outs to me. Well, shout outs to Ray. Shout outs to me from Jack Your Style, Ray. But if you're gonna ask me if I had to choose, I'll be very honest with you, I would take this over this. Now, why do you say that? Well, I also already own this, which is a far better rendition of the Shattered Backboard than this. First off, this is more true to the OG in terms of the color blocking, simply different. The toe box, this toe is satin, the back heel panel is satin, and then around the collar part is satin, and then this is leather. The sides are really nice leather. This is stitched, and I get it, a lot of people don't care for that, or the embroidered wings logo, but overall I think it is a better shoe than this. I feel like, first, well, listen, you can look at the value that people place on this versus this. People do think it's crazy that I wear this, and listen, a lot of times, even when I get those really limited shoes and I can make some money off of them, I still end up wearing them. Now, I'm not saying that's always gonna be the case. There could be a time where I let go of one of those, but as of right now, no. So I have this one, which means I definitely didn't feel a need to get this one. I know people kept saying, keep that same energy once the shoe comes out. Same energy has been kept. I'm a pretty consistent person, okay? What you see or hear, that's it. Pretty consistent person. So I didn't care for it when I first saw it. I don't care for it now, but a lot of you must have, because guess what? Pulled the shoe up on Sneakers Up at 10:03. I finally slept in for once in my life, well, adult life, and I slept until 10, but you know, saw on 10 at 10:03 that this was sold out on Sneakers App for grade school and for men's. Now, I know a lot of you did take some L's on quite a few apps, which Well, I'll take some L's. And then I saw some of you got some W's, so that's always a good thing. Certain people seem to hit more than others, and, you know, big ups to them. In terms of, listen, like, individual stores, and I can't stress this enough. If I say a certain store or a market that I happen to be in performed one way, it is not necessarily what happened in your area. I don't know how you people seem to not understand or comprehend this, but if I say a shoe happened to sell out in my area, it very well means it could sit in your area. Because I'm going to be honest with y'all, Houston, Texas seems to have everything sit. That's just one market I know where a lot of things seem to sit. Don't ask me why, because I don't know why. I don't live in Texas, okay? But a lot of things seem to sit in Houston, Texas, versus I could say certain things sell out here, and they can sell out in Chicago, they can sell out in LA, they can sell out in other smaller markets. But in terms of my area, this here, gone. It's gone. It's gone. And it was an extremely limited stock, too. And I think that's what people don't understand. They were saying, like, oh, this should be easy to get when it comes around. Not necessarily. We didn't have these in... And even in the quantity that we got, like the crimson tint ones, like to put that in perspective for you, and we didn't get a lot of those. So this was not a shoe that was just that easily sitting around. Oh, I got tons of pairs, I can take my time. No, you can't. No, you can't. So this is the Air Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard 3.0. You guys can let me know in the comment section and just be honest, because I don't have an issue with people that, like, I'm not somebody that just despises resellers. Like, I get it, they're part of the game now, so you take it for what it is. But did you go for the shoe because you really wanted it, or did you go for the flip? And I, listen, once again, there's no judgment here if you chose to go for the flip. There you go. Good luck at that finished panel. Like, I think this is a great shot. You can see exactly what it will look like. I do think an orange and camo just go extremely well together. So you guys saw me rocking the minimal camo pants with these today. A look I will probably do a lot. Big fan of that. And if you guys are still looking for these, I mean, you just kind of, you're gonna have to be on the lookout for a restock. I need more Jordan 1 lows. I have come to the conclusion that Jordan 1 lows, that's the way for me to be on. So I really want a black toe pair. I think I really do want the court purple pair, because it's looking mighty fine as well. The royal, are we calling it the royal one? Whoa, I don't care. I want a low pair. I don't want to settle for just the triple white, especially because we are moving into winter, but I gotta have it. Like, for the comfort you get with this toe box and just everything else, I absolutely love it. So I do want more of these, but this is the shoe of the month, I guess a lot of you were thinking. To me, the shoe of the month, hands down, was actually the Reebok Question, the mixed toe. That was the shoe of the month in terms of nostalgia, the value you get, the colorway. Everything about that was an amazing shoe. It's still something that's on my list, so I am hoping to maybe pick that up in November. We'll have to see. But, you know, just stay tuned for more videos. You guys already know I got a video for you tomorrow for Monday, Tuesday. We grinding. We on it. We on it. We on it. We on it. You guys already know. Thank you again for letting me hit 5K. This shoe is pretty much a sellout, so if you are able to go pick up pairs because people choose not to pick up their pairs in stores, or they happen to be sitting in your particular market because I have not really seen them in robust stock online, then go ahead and do that if it's a shoe that you want. You guys can check out Jumperman Chris's video in terms of the whole hold or sell thing, because not all of us can pinpoint all the time what the market is going to do for the shoe. Is what it is. But thank you so much for tuning into this video. As always, enjoy your weekend. Hopefully Michigan gets a win tonight against Notre Dame. If not, I'm going to be a sad person.